thanks for tuning into our close-up profile on Oscar winner Renee Zellweger. I'm Madison Michelle. After struggling for a couple of years making small indie movies, Renee became an overnight sensation thanks to her role in the romantic comedy Jerry Maguire. Her next few films failed to connect with audiences, but Friday the 13th, 2001 would prove to be very lucky for Renee. That's when her highly anticipated new film hit theaters, and it seemed everyone wanted to weigh in.
I'm freezing, Rose. I'm freezing.
What really sort of just catapulted Renee Zellweger into the public eye as a real actress, as somebody who's willing to kind of go out of her normal range of comfort, were the Bridget Jones films.
The film would prove to be a real stretch for the actress, especially around the waistline.
When they cast Renee Zellweger, who was American and pin thin, there was a lot of controversy and a lot of discussion from the people who love the book, both in the media and online. There were forums. Everybody wanted to give their opinion. But Renee Zellweger wanted to prove them wrong.
Only because of the responsibility that I felt to Helen Fielding, because she created such a beautiful character, and to the other people on the film, because I didn't want to be the weak link, and also because I knew that this book meant a lot to people, and it meant a lot to me.
The Wayfish star not only gained 25 pounds for the role, but she also added a convincing British accent to her repertoire.
Well, we've decided to really go for that this time.
One interesting fact about when Renee was prepping to do Bridget Jones is that she actually went to London and went undercover as a publishing house worker. Nobody knew that it was her because she really hadn't reached stardom by that point.
I moved to England in February, and I hung out and looked around and became familiar with the language and her cultural and social references that were not familiar to me. I worked with the dialect coach, of course, every day to get that part of it down.
I think of her as an English girl. I didn't know her as it because she was doing her English accent off the set as well as on. And I didn't know her as a Texan until the rap party, when she turned up with this weird voice.
She's perfect for Bridget, and because she's got something very lovable about her and funny about her, and she could be that girl.
No. And obviously, gaining weight and perfecting an English accent paid off because she was nominated for both an Oscar and a Golden Globe.
On the romantic front, the actress was reportedly dating one of the sexiest men alive.
She has been rumored to have dated George Clooney, though neither of them have acknowledged that this is either true or not true.
In October 2002, Renee appeared in White Oleander. Although her part was small, it was pivotal.
Renee Zellweger plays a sort of foster mother who takes in the Alison Lohman character. And it was an opportunity. She had not previously played a part like this, where she kind of played a maternal, more idyllic sort of character, somebody who genuinely cares, brings this girl into her home.
I love the characters in the book, and I loved how the mother-daughter relationship progressed as this young girl matured in foster homes. And Claire is an interesting character because, well, she's an interesting dichotomy of weakness and strength. She gets strength from giving, but she can't give to herself.
The film also gave Renee the opportunity to work with a very talented ensemble cast.
All people that I've admired from afar for so long, Robin Wright Penn, Cole Hauser, and of course, Michelle Pfeiffer.
She was just divine, you know, she was just, you know, she's so talented, and she worked so hard on this movie. I mean, they just worked her really long hours. And, you know, I mean, we've all, you know, done it, though. But it was really, really, I'm very fond of her.
But audiences were less fond of the movie. And White Oleander ended up in the red, grossing just over $16 million in the U.S.
Don't change that channel. Up next, Renee risks everything for a little razzle-dazzle and all that jazz.
I don't care if I fall down and break bones and humiliate myself and never work again.
And later in the show, how Renee busted out for the Bridget Jones sequel.
The fellas in my life responded really positively to those changes. And they said, gosh, Renee, wow. You might ought to consider keeping that stuff.